So my recently published book, Yoga in Modern Hinduism, Hariharānanda Āraṇya and Sāṃkhyayoga, is about its relation to pre-modern and modern traditions and transformations of yoga, and investigates the case of Hariharānanda Āraṇya and the Kāpil Maṭh tradition of Sāṃkhyayoga, which he founded. And I will draw on that material in the following. The Kāpil Maṭh tradition is the only living Sāṃkhyayoga tradition in India, and it's based on an orthodox Sāṃkhyayoga interpretation of the Pātañjalayogaśāstra, and is therefore an interesting case. Sāṃkhya and Sāṃkhyayoga are dualistic systems, consciousness, purusha, and the material principle, prakriti, are independent and separate, and there is also a multiplicity of selves, and these selves are ultimate principles. They do not merge with a higher principle. The goal is to realize contentless consciousness as separate from the mind and body. The full title of the combined text of Yoga Sutra and its commentary is Pātañjalayogaśāstra Sankhya Pravachana, the exposition of Yoga of Patanjali, the teaching of Sankhya. Patanjali, in other words, did think of his text as part of the Sankhya philosophy. It was only in around the 12th century that yoga began to be included as a name of a separate philosophical system in the list of philosophical systems in Hindu texts. In Pātañjalayogaśāstra, the goal of yoga is similar to the goal of Sankhya. The goal is not union or identity with Brahman, as in Vedanta, but knowledge of the separateness of the principle of consciousness and the principle of matter. In Sankhya of the Sankhya Karika, the separation is attained by means of knowledge, that is, by analyzing the 25 principles and cultivating witness consciousness. According to the Pātañjalayogaśāstra, the knowledge of the separateness of purusha and prakriti is attained by yogic discipline and concentration, that is samadhi, without content asam prajnati samadhi. Yoga does not here mean union, but cessation of the changes going on in the mind, citta vritti nirodha, which leads to realization of the isolation, kaivalya, of purusha from prakriti. In Sankhya Karika, Sankhya and Patanjali, Sankhya or Sankhya and Yoga, as these two philosophical traditions are commonly referred to, each person has a separate purusha that is ultimately real, and the purusha does not merge with any other principles, such as Brahman of Advaita Vedanta. Hariharānanda reiterates this point in his writings. Sankhya and Yoga are dualistic, while Advaita Vedanta is monistic. These systems are actually in opposition. In Sankhya and Yoga, consciousness and the material principle are ultimate and independent principles. The material principle is neither an illusion, Maya, nor does it merge in another principle. The idea of Brahman in Advaita Vedanta is that ultimate reality is one and that plurality is not real if considered different from Brahman. This differs from the view of Sankhya and Yoga. The famous scholar of Advaita Vedanta, Shankara, declared Sankhya as the main rival, Pradana Malla, of Advaita Vedanta. Many of the main ideas of Sankhya were nevertheless included in and used by the Vedanta philosophies. Early Advaita Vedanta adopted much from Sankhya, such as the tattvas and the three gunas of sattva, rajas and tamas. But they are nevertheless fundamentally different. So how did Hariharānanda get access to this orthodox Sankhya yoga as a practice? Sankhya was one of the ancient philosophical systems, and a text of Pātañjalayogaśāstra was part of that philosophical system. But Sankhya was at the time not a living system. There were no monastic institution based on Sankhya Yoga. Aranya became a sannyasin in 1892, 4 years before Vivekananda's Raja Yoga, and he lived the life of an ascetic promoting the teaching of Sankhya Yoga. Hariharānanda was one of the earliest Hindu sannyasins in the revival of yoga. He made the Sanskrit text Yoga Sutra, Pātañjalayogaśāstra, the foundation text for his spiritual practice, and understood that the Yoga Sutra, Pātañjalayogaśāstra, were part of the Sankhya philosophy. Hariharānanda represents a Sankhya yoga orthodoxy with emphasis on Sankhya as a dualist system of Indian philosophy, on the ancient Sankhya and Sankhya yoga texts, especially the Pātañjalayogaśāstra, on the Sanskrit language, on the traditional institution of sannyasin, and on kaivalya, freedom from samsara, as the only goal of yoga. And the world being viewed as mainly dukkha, a source of sorrow and suffering, as stated in the Yoga Sutra 2.15, dukkham eva sarvam vivekanaha. For the wise person, all is suffering. A unique feature of the Kāpil Maṭh institution is that the acharya lives permanently enclosed in an artificial cave, an institution Hariharānanda initiated, probably to emphasize the orthodoxy of his interpretation, as well as promoting the dualistic doctrine of Sankhya. Hariharānanda was from Howrah in Bengal, on the west bank of the river Hooghly from Kolkata, and from a wealthy, educated family. For most of his life, from 1892 to 1947, he lived the life of a Sankhya yoga ascetic. Aranya has been considered one of the most enigmatic figures in the early period of modern yoga. One reason is the mystery of the origin of his Sankhya yoga. His yoga appears orthodox. He combined the textual, scholastic yoga tradition of Sankhya yoga philosophy with a yoga practice, and is by some considered the only one who did this. Hariharānanda's yoga performance differed from modern yoga, which is mainly asana, that is body-oriented. His yoga is a yoga of meditation. He authored many texts in Sanskrit and Bengali on the theory and practice of Sankhya yoga. Hariharānanda had an excellent grasp of the Sanskrit language. He attracted a small number of disciples who themselves also became Sankhya yogins, a few monks and a small number of lay people, mostly Bengalis. In 1924, Aranya settled in Kāpil Maṭh in Madhupur, 300 kilometers northwest of Kolkata, where the main center of the Kāpil Maṭh institution remains to this day. Here he lived enclosed in an artificial cave from 1926 to 1947. Enclosing of the guru in a human-made cave for life is a characteristic mark of this yoga tradition. His most important work is considered to be the Bengali text Kapilashramiya Patanjal Jog Darshan, the yoga philosophy of Patanjali of the Kapilashram, a Bengali translation of the Sanskrit text Pātañjalayogaśāstra, with a detailed explanation of the text also in Bengali. So what is the historical relationship of the Sankhya yoga of Aranya to the ancient Sankhya yoga tradition and with the emergence of modern yoga? Was the Sankhya yoga of Hariharānanda a surviving lineage of ancient Sankhya yoga based on oral traditions, or was it a product only of the growing interest in yoga in the last half of the 19th century India that created modern yoga? What was the source of the Sankhya yoga of Aranya? Was it a survival of ancient Sankhya yoga by means of access to an oral lineage, or was it created based on access to printed Sāṃkhyayoga texts?